Hey everyone, this is username 404, and welcome back to part 4 of Let's Play Legend of Zelda The Minish Cap. Last part, we started the first half of Deepwood Shrine, got our first item, the Gust Jar, which allows us to suck stuff towards us. That's what we're going to do here on this lily pad. Oh. I've already figured it out, Eslo. Right. We also use it to propel ourselves. It's quite awkward to handle. Go. This bit's just... Fail. Yeah, this bit's just tedious and annoying, especially because of those flying pieces of shit. No, we don't want to go that way. We want to go right here. Navigate us around. That block's just annoying. No need for it to be there. Gonna go up here on these stairs, try not to get hit by that thing. Just kill it. There we go. And here we have another puzzle. Get off it. Yeah, we need to press it down to get that down, but if we're not on it. Yeah, you can't place pots down, so what you have to do is rid of a few and then push one onto it. Get that. Pretty simple. All the puzzles for this first dungeon are relatively simple because they're just trying to get you used to the mechanics. We go back up here, propelling ourselves. And we are in this bit, which we went into the last part. And yeah, we can move that here, and now we can get to this chest. Yes, the key. Right, now we have to backtrack. No, not that way. I'm so glad once this lily pad's gone, we don't have to use it anymore. Have to backtrack all the way. Yeah. Okay. Backtrack all the way back here. Tedium. This time we actually want to go up. Right. Okay. And just fast through here. Oh, shit, falling down. Yeah, you have to be right at the edge or unless it'll just count as you being falling into the water. Right. Here is the last major chest we need for this game. In this... Well, not in the whole game. God, that'd be... just in the whole game. Oh, I think I've done this wrong. No. I remember what you have to do. You have to suck that towards you. And... you have to get a bit closer. And do it. How are you in? Do the same on this one. And finally the same on this one. Ooh. No, I fucked that up. Go. Yes. And in here we have the boss key, or the big key as it says in this one. I'm probably just going to call it the boss key because I always do. And here we have a teleporter. Right, now we're back in the front dungeon. Front, in the lobby, I should say. Let's suck these away. And the more observant of you may have noticed that I've actually... where did I put start? No, I don't want to talk to you. I don't want to talk to you. There we go. Yeah. Still two treasure chests here, and I'm gonna go get those now. The first one, after you just go through this teleport here, which we triggered earlier in the game, and we get the piece of heart. And now we have four pieces to go against the dungeon. Which, again, is pretty cool. That's You get four pieces right at this before you even finish the first dungeon. In here, completely forgot about this one in the last episode, but let's just get rid of these things. It's another one where you have to use the gust jar to get rid of. Where is it? Yeah, get rid of the dust. So they're nothing important, they're just mysterious shells, but might as well just get them all. And the other one, go away, is down here. Can we push this up? Yeah. Let's get rid of these guys. I'll leave you alone if you leave me alone. Deal? Yeah, there's the final chest. Right. Yeah, let's go back to the lobby and head for the final boss. I can just push that up. Yes. Don't care about you guys, go away. Don't care about you guys. Right, here we are, back in the lobby. We'll go down left staircase first. With a final chest in the game. In the game. I keep saying in the game. Oh, that'd be disappointing if there was just that many chests in the whole game. No, in this dungeon. In the first dungeon. Such a fucking idiot. Right. Gotta use the gust jar again. Ourselves to the other side, and then do the same up here. Oh, cock it. Let's do this one properly. Right, here we have the boss dungeon. You can get hearts and these like in the lobby. I don't, yeah. Right, we're gonna have a little cutscene here to show where the boss is coming from. Yeah, these are called... I think in the second video I couldn't remember what they're called. They're called choo-choos, I think. And this one just seeps through the top. And then we just, like, walk in. So it's like... Ugh. It's not very pleasant. Okay, you done? You done? Yeah, there you are. Right. You can't just hit it. What we need to do is, like in every Zelda game, you have to you have to use the item you got in the dungeon to defeat it. So what we're going to do? Go away. We're going to use the gust jar. We're going to suck away its feet. And he's going to topple over. There we go. And we'll just wait. That should take that. But I think by the last one, he started going mental. I'll fall over. Wail on. Okay, this should be it now. Away. Fall on me. Okay, end boss. It's fairly simple. Yeah. They do get a bit harder, but yeah, first dungeon boss usually fairly straightforward. And here we have the earth element. I don't know what those are meant to be, but yeah, that's apparently Earth. And we get the next heart piece. So we've got five heart pieces, heart containers already now. And exit out here. Yeah, we'll go talk to the elder now. So let's head back to the Minish village. Yes, we are. I am pretty amazing. It's these guys are so... Stop looking. They just stare at you wherever you go. And it's really weird. Anyway, we've got to go off to the elders. Go into his abode. No, don't use the gust jar on his face. Yeah, we found the earth element. Right, yeah, now we've got to go find the actual smith to fix the Pecori blade. And he's gonna very slowly open the way. Thank you. I did everything. You just sat on fucking it. Whoa. He opened a curtain for us into his bedroom. That's kind of creepy. I think I need an adult. I can slip out the back passage. Bad choice of words. Yeah, we want to go in this little hut here before we grow again. Stop. I keep... Yeah, that's me. I'm pretty amazing. I see my reputation precedes me. And he just gives us bombs, which is pretty awesome. So now we can blow shit up. Fun, fun, fun. Yeah, we need to go down here and grow back to normal size. Oh yeah, these things, I can't remember what they're for, but you just talk to them and they disappear. But they don't work, go on. Yeah, I don't have the foggiest either. We need to use the bombs here. Blow up the wall. This is the exit to the Minish. Exit of the from the Minish Woods into these things. We can go across here using the thing, but we can't really do anything here. Well done, Link. So we're just gonna head up north. Bombable wall here. Just quickly blow up. And there is a treasure chest. No, don't bomb the treasure chest. That's one way to open it, but I don't recommend it. Right, open. And then, yeah, more mysterious seashells. But I don't think they're as good as in Link's Awakening, where collecting them just gives you an... get the fuck away. Gives you a... Oh, I don't care. We have... things again. Yeah, we're gonna head off in towards Hyrule Field, into Hyrule Castle, which I think is this is the correct direction. Yes. Why do I keep bombing everything? Right, I'm gonna end the video here. Don't forget to leave a comment and subscribe if you want to see more. I'm username404, and thanks for watching.